Well, Scully.
Scully.
They stole the body from an American metal band while on tour in D.C. 6 months ago.
The remains are male, late teens.
Significant staining on the Scarlet.
Scarlet.
It leached into the bone.
Dr. Thanks. Brennan.
The bone's done yet?
Yeah, I'll check the beetles.
Dr. Brennan, whatever you have there.
It's a piece of paper. That's all, with some writing on it.
Hey, there you go. You know, people in the desert don't have actual addresses. What's up with that?
Booth, you made it.
Yeah, you know, I'm touring the hottest places in the universe. Next stop, here you go. Hell.
I'm not really awake yet. Ah.
Last night before I left, I used my FBI powers to force the sheriff to send the skull back to the Jeffersonian. Talked to him this morning, you know, whew, seems a little resentful.
What time is it?
Let's go. Drink that on.
Don't read into anything the booth said. We're professionals. There's a line that doesn't even need to be there.
Not at all. I mean, if there were no more murders, I would probably not even, you know, see her.
It's very true.
Might have coffee.
Probably not.
What?
What?
You wouldn't even have coffee with me?
Well, in your scenario, we wouldn't even know each other because there are no murders.
Were. I said no more murders.
Then, fine. I mean, we could have a coffee. So that's clear, then. I mean, we'd have coffee. I mean, that's our relationship. Coffee.
Yeah, let's move on.
Don't...
Something wrong?
What's this?
Zach's Jane Doe. He said that you okayed the tissue markers.
No, that can't be right. That can't possibly be right. You did it wrong. It's a mistake, Angela.
All right, fine, sweetie. I'll turn it off.
Hmm? No, why would I mind? It's all right.
Which means it's a great time to hang up.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Ready?
Sweets?
Sweets is there?
Well, I think it's him.
Yeah, I had to meld to get information. Say that you're my
hey, baby. I have enough Bibles, thank you, but try next door.
You said I could be a school teacher.
Not the spinster kind who lives with his sister, but, you know, the hot one who makes the boys crazy. Here, put on the one that I picked out, all right?
Okay, but don't be so bossy.
We're newlyweds, I said. Taking Sin City by storm. Ready for action.
But you know, marriage is such an archaic institution.
Listen, Bones, I know what I'm doing, okay? I've done this before. Just stop arguing.
Well, I'm not. It's just, you know, I don't need a piece of paper to prove my commitment.
Fine. We're engaged.
Why would I be okay with engagement?
Whatever, Bones, all right? We're a loosely committed couple of hot high rollers. See, with money to burn. Because that is what's gonna get us in the door.
Like this?
Yeah. You like that?
Hey, Cam.
Dr. Brennan, judging by the angle of the blows, Billy's last opponent was 5'6 and left-handed.
With a fist size of approximately 90 millimeters. Zach measured.
That's hot.
Hot?
Wait a minute. What's hot?
Nothing.
Vegas. It's hot. It's very hot here.
How does anyone actually walk in these things?
Well, you know, them boots, they ain't made for walking, sweetheart.
That was completely over the top.
All right, you know, you play your part and I'll play mine.
Hey, boy. Hey, girl.
Let's see. 5'6", southpaw.
And left-handed.
Can I help you folks?
I can't believe it, huh? Sloppy Joe Nolan.
Sloppy Joe?
Yeah, that's how he left his opponents.
These days, it's just Joe.
Hey, busted a lace, Joe.
Sorry to bother you, Joe, but, you know, you had a huge impact on my style back in the Army. You know, in a juke to the body, followed by a right hook. Worked for me every time.
Another Army fighter, Joe? How many has-beens you getting here a week?
Well, at least this one still looks like he's in shape.
Oh, yeah, my man's in great shape. Believe me.
Easy there, honey.
Well, let's see it, homie. Show us those moves that made you so famous.
Yeah, go ahead, Tiger. Show these clowns.
Yeah, maybe I will, okay? Just this a little.
Yeah, come on, Tiger.
Let's see, Joe. Get a little, tap, juke to the body with a hard right. By a whole bunch of you.
So much for my has-been army fighter.
Not bad.
I still got it.
Yeah, maybe a little
touch. What's your name?
Tony Scallion. Here's my fiance, Roxanne.
Yeah, we're more engaged to be engaged.
So you looking to train or what?
I don't fight no more. But they say that you could direct me and Roxy to a little, underground action.
They say a lot, don't they?
That was some guy at the Rio. One of them, you didn't hear from me types.
Sorry. Can't help it.
What'd I tell you, Tony? That guy was just trying to hit on me.
Well, I do know a number you can call. Not that I give it to just anybody.
Oh, come on, Joe. They seem like such nice people.
Yeah, we're nice people.
$1,000 each.
Oh, that's a little steep.
No, Tony, come on. We only live once. We want to see a fight.
Not like being a kept man, huh?
Yeah, I don't know what I'd do without her. That was amazing. What got into you?
It's from when I used to watch old movies with my dad. He really liked Claire Bow.
Claire Bow was a silent film star.
Yeah, but I guess that's how I always imagined she sounded.